anything that can be massively parallelized ought to go on something other than the CPU, right? Like if you've got an enormous amount of parallel instructions to run, you want something with an enormous amount of cores.
But everything has an enormous amount of parallel instructions to run.
Well, but lots of the stuff that we do is inherently a sequential series of steps. It's like the critical path.
Nothing we do is an inherent series of sequential steps. In fact, I challenge you to do almost anything that is literally a series of 4 billion sequential steps. It's almost impossible. And the reason for that is because humans can't conceptualize anything even remotely like that. So typically what we do is we use loops over many things. And every time there is a loop over many things, it is very rare that it can't be parallelized, at least at the instruction level, meaning SIMD, but usually it can also be parallelized at the thread level, with very minor changes, if you need changes at all. Sometimes you do, sometimes you don't. What we don't have is a language that makes it likely to express what you were doing in a way where the parallelism is easy for a computer to determine.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah, I guess... I'm trying to think through what is it that made me think about life as mostly being sequential steps? I think it's probably that things that can be effectively parallelized end up being a library call quite often. So by the time you're writing code, a lot of the stuff you end up doing is... Oh, so in the world of... Okay, if you're writing a game engine, which you have been, then yes, a lot of it will be doing all of the parallelizing. But if you're writing the game, then most of the stuff you'll be doing will be short pieces of logic that pass, you know, top to bottom through a function. There's no point saying this series of 10 quick things that this one unit is going to do this frame, I'm going to try and parallelize it, like just run them in order.
I can tell you two things related to that example, if you.
Well, like. I'm sort of thinking out loud. So now I'm thinking, okay, in an imaginary thing where you've got a load of units, actually all of them are probably running that short set of instructions in parallel.
Right, I was going to say two things. So number one, like I said, it's not really possible for a human to conceptualize 100,000 units, all of which are running completely different code. Because if that was true, you had to write 100,000 and then the update functions. No one's going to ever be able to balance that game, right?
No.
You know that many units will be running similar code paths, which could easily be vectorized, right? Number two is that, well, okay, so suppose that unit's running code that's totally different than every other unit. Well, what's to stop another CPU from updating a different unit, right?
Yeah.
And so usually when you look at code, the problem is not that it couldn't have been parallelized both wide and multi-thread, but rather that the way we write these programs, there's no way for a compiler to know that. It doesn't know, right? Because sometimes some of those units are going to do something like apply damage to another unit, right? Now, it's pretty easy to construct a parallel program where that can run parallel and that gets resolved at some sane place. But a compiler can't do that. It doesn't know how it would reorganize the code to make that make sense. Now, if the programming language instead had been like shaders, where typing in game entity code naturally leads to something where things like updating cross entity are in a separate section because that's the paradigm for this programming, or that programmers, when they were taught, understood that writes to other entities happen at the end, all of a sudden now we can do all of that work. So the problem is not that there are actual serial dependency chains. The problem is the compiler doesn't know where the serial dependency chains are because writes to and from memory could need, for all it knows, you wanted those to be sequential. 99% of the time they didn't need to be, but it doesn't know. It doesn't know which the 1% are, right? And so pretty much any program you run today, can definitely be parallelized, both SIMD and Thread. It's very rare to find one that can't, but it's not possible to do it automatically. And that's the real challenge going forward for these languages.
Mm.
Which coincidentally, no one's working on. So that's great.
Great.